Okay, so it's been a nice 5 minutes introductory session. I'm Ashish here. I will tell my name to everybody. And I have been working on automation since 2005. Okay, I work on pretty number of tools, but one of the most famous tools which I've ever worked on is Selenium. It's going it's getting a lot and lot famous these days, and a lot of people are demanding this because it's a free tool. Okay, it's a tool which can test your web-based application. It's only the tool. It's Selenium is only the tool which can test your web-based application. It's Selenium can only test your web application, right? Now Selenium is not something which was made in one day. It evolved a period of time. Over a period of time, it evolved, and I tell this story in every class that initially in 2007, when I first worked on this tool, there were three components. One was known as RC, one was known as IDE, one was known as Grid. Okay, giving you a brief background, IDE is still used. It's a tool which only works on Mozilla. This is one of the major disadvantages. It cannot generate reports like HTML reports or something, right? And IDE is a simple record run tool, although it can do lot of other things as well apart from recording and running, but it's not a tool which can be used at a very large scale. A large scale, like you have got 10,000 test cases to be automated, and you need the reports to be generated. The script has to be run for around, you have to run the script for around say 5 hours or 6 hours or one day. Then IDE is not a preferred tool. If you have a website which is of 2 or 3 pages, the work is very less, right? And then you can use IDE. But if you have complex application which has to be tested on multiple browsers and all, then there used to be something known as Selenium RC. RC worked on multiple browsers, okay, and it supported multiple languages. Now to work with Selenium RC, you had to learn any one of the languages, like you had to learn Java or C sharp or PHP, Ruby, okay, it's also available with Python. Well, you must, many of you must be knowing this. Okay, guys, I'm starting with the very basics because there are people in the training who are not at all aware of the basics of Selenium as well, right? So if you know this information, just be patient. Okay, as we proceed with the course, we'll go from simple to quite advanced things. Okay, now Grid. Grid is something which can help you to run your test cases parallelly. Okay, what we do in Grid is that we have a central machine known as hub. Okay, this hub we connect it to various machines, right? And on all these machines which are connected to hub, we can run the test cases parallelly. Okay, that means suppose if I have got 30 test cases, I can distribute them. On this machine I will execute 10, on this 10, and on this 10. Further, I have the control that these 10 test cases can also be run parallelly in one machine, these 10 cases parallelly on one machine, then these 10 test cases parallelly or serially, whatever you want. Okay, you can further control the test cases. This reduces the time and effort to run the test cases. Okay, or in my experience, what I have seen is generally that people, they in Grid, they connect the central hub, they connect 3 machines to it. On one machine they run all the test cases on I, on another machine on Mozilla, and on the third machine they run on Chrome. This is what I have seen people doing most of the times with Grid. Okay, now the most famous thing which actually got famous earlier in 2007 was this RC, because it could support multiple languages, multiple browsers and all, but it had lot of drawbacks. The primary drawback of RC which I felt was it had a server which had to be started and stopped manually. Okay. Now, at times the server never used to start up. Then people used to tend to log off their computers and log in again, and that was not a very easy thing to do. Okay, it wasted a lot of time. Plus, RC was not very rich as well. There were many things which were not so easy in RC. Okay. For example, you have to go to a website and print the names of all the links present on the home page of the website. This is a simple problem. Go to xyz.com and get the total number of links on the home page and print the names of all the links. Okay. Now, what used to happen was this thing, this scenario, you can implement it in RC. It's not so tough, but it was not so simple as well. All right. Now, considering this into the fact and considering many other points as well, Google along with few other guys, they made WebDriver. All the Google applications, Gmail and all, whatever you use, AdWords and all these things are automated with Selenium. Google uses Selenium and they are the major people behind WebDriver. Okay. So this was the new version WebDriver. Now WebDriver was completely different. Officially it's not a product of Google. It's owned by ThoughtWorks. There's a company called ThoughtWorks. It's owned by them. Okay. Officially Selenium is owned by ThoughtWorks. It's a small company, but it's a very good one. And yes. So I'm not very sure who is the owner. Maybe there's a collaboration or something, because they never mentioned this on the website. Okay. But it's a free tool. Anybody can use it. Anybody can contribute. Even if you come across something tomorrow and if you want to contribute towards Selenium, you can do that. Okay. Yes. No license required for parallel execution. For distribution tests and all, there is no license required. That's why this tool is getting famous, right? It's difficult to work on this tool. It's difficult than PewDiePie to work on this tool, but it's getting famous because you don't have any cost involved in this. Okay, if I have to automate a test case on PewDiePie, it takes me 5 minutes to automate a test case in PewDiePie. Then I'm sure I'll take at least 15 minutes to automate it on Selenium. But once it is automated, it's done. Okay. Would it be stupid to have, but can we use grid to run? Execution in a single machine parallel? Yes, Rahul, you can do that, but that is not recommended. The question being asked is that, can I use grid on a single machine and on a single machine I can run the test cases parallelly? You can do that, but the makers of grid, they don't recommend this. Probably some technical issue or something. Okay. Right. Now WebDriver is the new version and it also supports multiple browsers, multiple languages, all the features are there. Okay. But it is entirely different from RC. People who have worked on RC for 5 years or 6 years, when they look at the WebDriver code, they are not able to understand it. Okay, so don't think that if you want to learn WebDriver, you have to learn RC. That's not the thing. Okay, and one more thing, people think that if my website is made in Java, then I have to use Selenium with Java, or if my website is made in Ruby, then I have to use Selenium with Ruby. No, it's not like that. Your website, it can be in any language. You can use any one of these languages. It is independent. If my website is made in PHP, I can use Selenium with Java. Okay. Right. Now, Selenium RC code and WebDriver code are entirely different. That's why few minutes back I told you not to migrate the code. Now, what these guys they have done is they have provided us with a bridge. That bridge is known as Selenium WebDriver backed Selenium. With that bridge, you can migrate your code from RP to WebDriver, but I have seen people having like bad experiences doing that. Okay, so what I recommend is delete the code in RC and make new one in WebDriver. That will save you more time. Okay, right. So don't use this bridge. Right. Probably I can be wrong. Okay, because I personally have used this bridge just once. I also faced some issues, but I have seen people really going crazy while using this thing. Okay, so now IDE is the same, right? And grid has evolved to something known as grid 2, which also supports WebDriver. Okay, grid 1 used to support RC, grid 2 will support WebDriver. Okay, examples of the problems I faced or something. Well, see, with the problem I faced was, for example, there is a link on the website. On RC, the link, I was able to click on the link, but on web, using the bridge, when I converted it to WebDriver, I was not able to click on the link, right? Then eventually I had to use JavaScript and all those things, and it's not so easy. Okay, right? Now, what we'll be doing in this training, we'll be first studying Java. Java is very important. People tend to skip this. People think that fine, I know Java, I did Java, or I did programming long time back, I'm aware of it, I can do it. No, don't think like that. Look, if you know Java, you don't need a training for Selenium, to be very frank. Okay, people come to me for training just because most of the time they are not aware of the Java concepts, right? Up to what extent we have to learn Java? You have to learn it to a good extent. You have to learn core Java. Okay. Look, Java will not just help you in Selenium. Right. I am not talking technical things right now. I will talk it in some time. Right. Java will not just help you in Selenium. For example, you have to learn a tool, say SOAP UI tomorrow. Java will help you over there. Right, just learn it once and I am sure you will apply it in multiple tools, or JMeter as well. JavaScript is there in JMeter, but it will help you. Right, so you just don't run away from programming language, learn Java language, and I am sure you will be able to grasp lot of other testing tools as well. I am telling you this from my experience. Okay, so now going further, right. Till what extent Java is required? Java is required to a good extent, and I'll be teaching you. Look, I'll tell you a practical thing. People come and tell me that fine, Ashish, there's no documentation on Selenium on the internet. The documentation is there. If you go to the website of Selenium, that is seleniumhq.org, and if you go to the download section, right? In the download section, there will be a link called Java Doc over here. This is the technical documentation of Selenium. Okay, if you click on Java Doc over here, you will get this documentation. But it's not for everybody, right? You need to have the concept of object oriented programming very, very clear with you. Okay. You need to have object oriented programming, the concept of object oriented programming. Once you learn these concepts, it is a child's play to understand this documentation. I also understood Selenium from this documentation. Right? So let's continue with Java language. Let's see. I think everybody must have installed Java on their machine, because this WebEx session requires Java to be installed. If you have a 64 bit machine, which almost everybody is having these days, right? I would recommend you to install JDK as well. Fine. Go to Google and type download JDK. Okay, this will be the link. You go to this link and click this. Download JDK over here depending on your operating system and install it. Fine. please do this. If you have a 64-bit machine, it's mandatory. If you have a 32-bit machine, it's up to you. I do that. I have a 32. I still do it. Okay. Now, the first and foremost thing is that you need to download Eclipse. Eclipse is the editor for Java language. Fine. Now, before I download Eclipse, I am assuming in this training a basic thing that you guys at least know what if statements are, what for loops are, basically what statements, what loops and functions and variables are. Is there anybody who is not aware of these basic things? Loops, variables, arrays, functions, statements. Is there anybody? Please be frank. I'll tell you what to do. Okay. If you are not so comfortable, because you know what, I cannot spend my time on these things. I have limited time in online training. There are people who expect advanced things from me as well. I have to cover them. Right. You can go to my site. Just watch training video 1 as well as 2 in your spare time. These are free videos. Okay. They will tell you about loops, arrays, functions, statements and introduction to Java as well. Right. Meanwhile, I'll also tell you a little bit about Java. The first thing is that you need to download Eclipse. Right. Go to the first link over here and you can download. Hold on. Yeah, you can download Eclipse IDE for Java EE developers. This one. Depending on your operating system, whether it is 32 bit or 64 bit, you go forward and download it. Right. Once you have downloaded Eclipse onto your system, it will look. You extract the zip file. Okay. Once you extract the zip file, you will get a folder like this, Eclipse. Okay. Are you, I think my font will be a little small. Hold on. Just a minute. Just a minute. How's now? Is it better now? I've increased the resolution or decreased the resolution. Or was it better earlier? Is it okay now? Better now, fine. So we'll get a folder called Eclipse over here. Right, and in this folder you will have eclipse.exe file. Eclipse is not an it never comes as an installable. Okay, it comes as a bundle. Fine, you just have to run this eclipse.exe and Eclipse will start. You don't have to install it. Fine. This is the initial window, which is the workspace launcher. Out here you have to tell the path where you will be keeping all the projects. I'll be keeping my projects in July weekend folder and hold on, let it start. Right. So now this is Eclipse. It's started. And this is the welcome page. I'll close this. And this is my Eclipse. Right. Now in Eclipse, in general, on the left hand panel over here, we'll keep our projects. Right. At the central point panel, we'll do the coding. And at the bottom, we'll see the output. Okay. Right. So now what is the difference between Eclipse Helios and Eclipse Juno? Look, Juno is the new version. Helios is the older version. They have added lot of features, but Vijay, you don't have to really worry. Okay. You can use any. Eclipse is primarily for developers. For developers, it makes a lot of difference if they use Helios or Juno. For us, we just have to work with Selenium. It doesn't really make a difference. Okay. I need your help with Selenium installation on Mac. I'll tell you today how to do it. In the second half of the training, after 1 hour, I'll tell you how to do it. Okay. How to configure Selenium. Right. Now, I'll make my first Java project. That is file, new, other. Go to other. Expand Java. If you forget all these things, I'm recording the session. You can also look at the recorded session later on. Fine. You select new Java project and give the project name. I'll call it day one. Right. So this is a simple Java project which is created on the left hand side. Okay. If you expand this, it will have a source folder. Fine. Inside the source folder, you create a new class, right? Or before that, the important thing is that at times we will need to right click on the project and hold on, my clips have hanged. 1 minute. Yeah, at times you will feel the need that you right click on the day one folder. Go to the properties. And just a minute, guys. Just 1 minute. Yeah, so you'll have to go to the project and properties. These are the various parameters over here, right? You click on Java build path, all right, and go to the library section over here. This one, so you will require this a lot, fine. And I'm telling you later on, you'll get used to it. In the resource part, you will see the project location, the physical location on the disk, right? At times, you will feel the need. I don't want to open the project in Eclipse. I want to go to the hard disk and see where the files are, right? So you, this is the physical location. You can go to this location. And you see the day one project. Okay. In day one, you will see various projects, various folders. And in among all these folders, only the source folder you will be able to map inside Eclipse. Rest, what all these things what are, you'll get to know with time as we proceed with the course. Dot project file, it denotes that this is an Eclipse project. Do not delete this file, otherwise this project will not open in Eclipse. Okay, dot project file denotes that this is a Eclipse project. Fine. Now all the Java coding for Selenium will be doing inside Eclipse. Inside the Eclipse, when we run the program, the browsers will open and all that stuff, right? So Eclipse is the starting point. Okay. So the first, I'll make my first Java file. I'll right click on the source folder, select new class. Okay. New class, and I'll name that class as sample Java. Fine. And select this. I'm sorry. Select this checkbox, public static void main, right? And you click on finish. So what will happen is that you'll see some code generated over here. I'll just increase the font size so that you are able to see it clearly, the code and all. Hold on. Okay, this is the first sample program, right? Now in this file you will see lot of things like public, what is static, void, right? At this point of time I cannot explain all this stuff, what public is, what static is and all everything. Okay, so just be with me as we proceed with the course, you will get to know what all these things are. Fine. just accept these things as they are right now, and let's first execute a program. As I continue explaining you the concepts of object oriented programming, right, you will come to know what static is and access modifiers, you will come to know what public is, right. But just for time being, understand this is the main function. In this function, the control comes up when you run the program. For example, in C language, right, in C language, when you run the program, where does the control comes? It comes in the main function, right. Similarly, in Java, there is a main function in which the control comes. Suppose inside the main function I have to type in something, I can write over here system.out.println. This is the command to type something, right. So I can write over here learning Selenium. Okay, so now when you run this, how to run this, this is the icon to run. Okay, this icon you can click on and your code will execute, or you can right click on your Java file, go to run as Java application, right. You can also execute it like this. Shortcut is Alt Shift X, right. Now command to print something is system.out.println, shortcut is SYSO, then you hit the control space bar of your keyboard and it will come up automatically. You don't have to write everything. Shortcut is SYSO plus control plus space. Okay, now I am assuming you know what at least int is. If I write int I equals to 100, it can store a number. String s equals to hello, it can store a string, right. I am assuming you know at least these things, what statement is, what a loop is, for loop and all, what a function is, fine. I again repeat, if you don't know, just go and at least watch the training video too, right, you will come to know, right. Now if you go to the physical location where the project is lying, okay, my project is lying over here, right. Inside the source folder you will be able to see sample.java, which is opened inside Eclipse, okay. And corresponding to the sample.java, if you open up your win folder, you will see a file sample.class file. If you try to open this, even if you open it in a say notepad, you will not be able to understand what's written inside it, okay. What happens is that every Java file when you execute or compile the program, it converts into a class file. This class file is like the exe file, executable file, which you can execute on any platform like Windows, Linux or Unix or Stellaris, any operating system you can execute. This class file is just like an exe file. Corresponding to every Java file, a class file is made, right. So just a minute, okay. So now if you, where was I? I'm sorry. Yeah. Corresponding to every Java file, a class file is made. Fine. If I make another Java file, if I make a new class called as say sample2.java, and inside it I print just hello, and if I run this, this will print hello. And if you look at the physical location in the bin folder, you will have sample2.class file generated, okay. Class file is like an executable file. Now if your client, he wants the project, he, you will not give him the Java files because you don't want to give him the code. So what you give him are these files, class files, Okay, and he can execute these class files at his machine. When you deploy the project on a server, okay, to execute, when the developers, you all of you must know, like the deployments, they happen in the companies, right? You say the deployments are happening, you know, 2 hours it will take to end the deployment. What happens in the deployment? In the deployment, these class files, they are deployed on the server to be executed. Okay, Java files are not. Java files are for the developers to see the code, but class files, they keep the information hidden, they are executables. Okay, but the question arises over here, what if I have got many class files, say 1000 class files, because on enterprise level the projects are huge. Okay, so what we do is that, look, I think my speakers are not working. If anybody has tried to speak out, I think I'll not be able to hear you. In the break, we'll take a break in between. I'll take out my speakers. I don't want to do that right now. So if you want to ask a question, just text me right now. Okay, I'm not sure about the speakers, so that's why I'm telling you. Right. So where was I? I was telling you that these class files, there can be many class files. Okay, you cannot just put single class file and deploy it on the server. So what we do is that we bundle all these class files in a single file. We put them in a single file known as a jar file. Okay, so jar file is nothing but collection of many executable class files, and class files are made from Java files. So what happens is that from Java files we made class files, and from we collect many class files together and put them in a single file known as a jar file. Okay, and that single file you can put it on a server or deploy something, right? Now what happens, giving you a practical example, what happens when you download and install Java on your machine? In your project, do you see this JRE system library? Okay, what happens when you download and install Java on your machine? Right, nothing but all these jar files are configured in your system. Java is nothing but Java is a set of jar files, and each of these jars, right, they hold number of class files. You see that it's huge, it's very vast. Okay, so the Java developers, they never wanted to give you the source code of the files which they made, right? They gave you the class files, right? For example, if I write over here date is a simple file. Date.class is a simple file inside one of the class files. It's over here. You see that date.class. It signifies the date. If you want to do some date operations, date or time operations, you can do it with this class. So these all are internal classes, and all of them are inbuilt and all of them are in the Java files, right? Now why am I teaching you this is because when you have to integrate Selenium in your project, okay, is it mandatory or a guideline to have a single class inside a single Java file? You know, you can have multiple as well, but in Selenium we don't do that, Rahul. We don't do that in Selenium. You can have multiple. Okay, so now as I was telling you, what is Java? Java is nothing but set of jar files, right? Now if you want to configure Selenium in your system, you just have to include the jar files of Selenium. Okay, what the developers of Selenium did, right? They hold on, if you go to seleniumhq.org and you go to this download section, right, you will see the download link over here in front of Java client drive. You can download this thing, right, it will be a zip file, you can download it. When you download it, the version, latest version is 2.33, okay, and when you download this, you will get is this folder. When you extract the zip file, you will get this folder, okay, and inside this folder you will see these two jar files. Now these two jar files are provided by Selenium guys, okay. Selenium never comes as a EXP file, it comes inside jar file. These are the two jar files and the other jar files are inside the library directory, right. For Mac based operating system or any other operating system, you have to download these jar files only if you want to work with Selenium. So these are the two jar files and the other jar files for Selenium are inside library. Now you need to bring these jar files inside Eclipse. Which jar files are already present inside Eclipse? Only the Java jar files are present, okay. So if you want to make this project Selenium ready, import the Selenium jar files in the project. For that you have to go into the properties of the project again, right, and you have to go to Java build path, this thing, okay. And in Java build path you will have the library section. This is the library section, okay. In this there will be a button known as add external jar. You will see that currently the Java jar files and all Java is there in the project libraries, right. You can add external jars and you can select the Selenium jar files which you have downloaded. These are the two jar files. And don't forget to add the jar files under library directory as well. Don't forget, okay. People forget this and then they fall into trouble and they reach me that Ashish, Selenium is not working, right. They forget to introduce or they forget to include these all jar files in the project. So you have to include all these jar files in the project and when you are done with it, you will see a referenced library section coming up over here in the project. Under this, the jar files of Selenium are present, okay. So this is how you configure Selenium inside Eclipse. Selenium is not installed. I see many people saying I want to install Selenium. QTP is installed, okay. Selenium is not installed, right. I will repeat again, right click on the project, go to the properties. I am recording this session, you can also have a look, also look at the recorded session, right. Don't worry if you forget this. Go to the Java build path option, okay, and you will see four tabs. Select the libraries tab, right, and click on add external jars. And select all the jar files, the jar files under library and these two jar files, and include them in the project. When you include them, you will see them coming under reference libraries, okay. I think somebody is trying to talk, I am not able to hear. Hold on, I think my speaker, just a minute, I am checking my speaker, give me 1 minute. This seems to some problem with my speaker. Can you just write your question on WebEx? I'll answer it. Right. So fine. Okay. Or you can also use Skype. Right. So now. Right. We have already started it. Anyways. So any questions from whatever I have taught till now, any question I have taught you about simple Java, making a project, making a single file, and I taught you how to include the Selenium library or in the project. Any question with this? No question? Okay. So now, in order to use this library, okay, you need to understand the concept of object-oriented programming. No, you don't have to do the installation now. You can also do it after the class. Look, guys, what I recommend you is that don't practice parallelly with me. Okay, because I want you guys to understand it first. If you want to practice parallelly, I'll give you the recorded video as well for the class. Looking at the video, you can practice it parallelly as well. Okay, don't practice parallelly with me, because just concentrate, understand the concept. When you look at the video again, you can do it. Right? So now I will teach you the concept of object-oriented programming, and I'll tell you how that concept is used inside Selenium. Fine? Because most of the times people, they tend to ignore that, and then they fall into the trouble, right? Especially if things are not working, and if you don't know Java, then you really get confused. Okay? Do you have assignments as well? Yes, Rahul, I give assignments, but I don't give assignments for initial 3 classes or so. Initial 3 to 4 classes, I don't give assignments. From the 5th class, I start giving the assignments, because I have take you to a certain level, right? And then I give you examples and assignments to automate sites and various websites and all. Okay? Right? So, now, let's do